that we actually recognize what we are dealing with at hand, how can dharmic people around the world help foreign audiences better understand our cultures and traditions?
Okay, so you have people who are living in India who are being prejudiced and stereotyped in the media for being Indian, that Indophobia is happening and Hindu phobia is happening when you look at the media portrayals of India, which is offensive, and that no other religious or Indigenous culture in the world would have to put up with that, because they would be branded racists and they would be put under the spotlight for vilifying people on the grounds of religion. So I think that people who are outside of India need to start talking to the people within their own institutions, whether it's the media, whether it's academia, whether it's politics. They need to start talking and building good relationships and teaching them about what comprises Hindu phobia and how not to do it. But Hindus need to stand together and support one another. That's my observation. They need to stand up and not, like Lord Krishna said, don't be impotent cowards. You need to stand up. And he had to really, you know, he took a long time to convince Arjun that he had to stand up and not be a coward. So, you know, read the Gita and understand that message. Obviously, everybody reads the Gita, but I think that needs to be deeply, deeply penetrated, that there's a time when it's right to stand up and to fight, because we need to each do that according to our Swadharma, whether it's by pen, you know, whether you're in the military, whether you're working in healthcare, you know, you can do it in every part of the society, is to support and stand with one another so that there is no discriminatory treatment of Hindus within our societies. Right. But in the West, we have very strong, you know, regulations and legislation. And if you don't speak to the system and report it, then they don't know it's happening. So, you know, in the West, there's this kind of religious freedom, which is celebrated as part of our, you know, our ethos, our cultural ethos. But if you don't go and report any act, whether it's just prejudice or bias in the classroom, whether your child comes home from school and they've been bullied at school, if you don't report that to the principal, and you let it wash over, it's just really, it's opening the door for more violence. So it's not an act of pacifism. It's actually an act of himsa. Because when you ignore violence and you don't report it and you think that it's going to go away, what that does is it leaves space for more violence to occur. And this is why this is growing exponentially, because there's like, you know, 1.5 to 2 million Hindus outside of India, and there's only half a dozen or a dozen that have actually stood up and spoken against Hindu phobia. So where are all these voices? And if we want to be heard, then we need to speak. And the democratic system, you know, it allows that. It actually wants people to speak and to uphold their own civil rights. And we won't get anywhere if we don't. Unfortunately, it's the victim that always has to make the report. Nobody's going to come and save us. We need to stand up and take the initiative and use the available you know, systemic protections that we have, because they're there. We just need to use them, and when they're not there, we need to make them aware that they need to be there, that there are no protections or there is no recourse. For example, with this university, it's outrageous because there's such a breach of academic freedom parameters.
Yes.
And yet there's no response. I mean, they're breaching their own rules. We've got rules. And if I breach those rules as an academic, then my university can take action against me. So I need to be careful. And so do all of us. And that includes the people that are making this Hindu phobic rhetoric, that's smearing everybody as a terrorist. This needs to be outlawed within academia and the media before people get hurt, because we've just seen Dotbusters return in America. So we don't want to wait until people are killed on the streets before action is taken. So everybody needs to step up. It's time now for people to step up. That's my opinion.
Please remember to subscribe to us and switch on the notifications for this channel. For our other social media links, more content, and to support our work, please visit citti.net. Dhanyavaad. Namaskar.